Hi students, in the last class we discussed the theorems 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, but it is not properly have in the yesterday class. Today I have to explain this three theorems in detailed manner. Look at this board. Theorem 1.3, let x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates, then x can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p comma q are coprimes, and the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n comma m are non-negative integers. Further examples, 0.375, that is 375 by 1000. Now that is LCM numerator multiplied with 1000. Denominator also multiply with 1000, it should be 375 by 1000. While doing cancellations, we get 3 by 8. This is the rational number. So, in the similar manner, 1.04, it can be written as numerator multiply with 100, denominator also multiply with 100, you get 104 by 100. While doing factorizations and cancellation of 2 square and 2 square here, 2 is remaining, 2 into 13, 26 by 25, 2 square into 5 square, 25. This is also P by Q form. And the third example, 0.875, multiply the numerator and denominator with 1000, you get 875 by 1000, and the prime factorization doing time, 5 cube and 5 cube are cancelled, 15 is remaining in the denominator, 2 power 4 is 16, 16 into 5, 80. 7 into 1, 7, 7 by 80, P by Q form. 12.5, example 4. So, 125 by 10, that is 5 cube by 2 into 5, 15 cancel, 5 square is there, 5 square value is 25, 25 by 2. So, go through the definition once again. X be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates. In the 4 examples, the decimal expansions are terminate. Then x can be expressed in the form of p by q. So all terminating decimals are expressed in the form of p by q. This is the theorem 1.3. And I will send you a WhatsApp photograph and write the notes clearly. This is the clear notes about the yesterday's class. Once again, I have to give the details. Now go through the theorem 1.4. Let x is equal to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integers. Then x has a decimal expansion which terminates. This theorem 1.4 is quite converse of 1.3. So here we have to take all p by q forms. 3 by 8, 3 by 2 cube, the numerator and denominator multiply with 5 cube here, you get 375 by 2 into 5, 2 power 3 into 5 power 3, 10 cube, because I multiply the numerator and denominator with 5 cube. So you get 5 cube value is 125, 3 is 375. 2 cube into 5 cube, 2 into 5 whole cube, that is 10 cube. 10 cube value is 1000, 375 by 1000. Similarly, 26 by 25, 2 into 13 by 25 can be written as 5 square. That is why the numerator and denominator multiply with 2 square, you get 2 square value is 4, this is 26, 26 4s are 104 by, this is 5 square into 2 square, 10 square. So 104 by 10 square value is 100. Again, In the example 3, 7 by 80, 7 by 80 can be written as 16 into 5, 16 can be written as 2 power 4 into 5, that is why I multiply the numerator and denominator with 5 cube, we get 5 cube value is 125, 125 7s, 875 by, this is 5 power 4, 2 power 4, 2 into 5 whole power 4, 10 cube, 10 power 4, that is 10,000, 875 by 10,000. Again, example 2, 4, 25 by 2. So the denominator multiply with 5. Similarly, numerator also multiply with 5. 25 5 is 125 by 10 P by Q form. So that see the theorem 1.4 once again. Let x is equal to P by Q. All the examples are 1, 2, 3, 4 are in the form of P by Q. Such that the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m. In the 4 examples, the denominators are in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. 2 power n into 5 power m. Then the decimal expansions are in the form of P by Q. Since the theorem 1.4 is quite converse of 1.3. Now theorem 1.5, this is about non-terminating recurring decimals. Non-terminating recurring decimals. Let x is equal to P by Q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of Q is not of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n comma m are non-negative integers, then x has a decimal expansion which is non-terminating, repeating or recurring. Here example 1 I have to took here 1 by 7. 7 is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So that when we divide this one, we get 0.142857. So 142857, 142857, like that continuously coming, the bar notation of the decimal expansion is 0.142857 bar. The decimal expansion also explained here. So that these three theorems are very, very, very useful to us. Okay, children? Afterwards, using these three theorems, you have to do the exercise. That is 1.3. 1, 2, 3 Romans. These three Romans are you do by yourself. And example 5, example 6 also. Okay, children? It takes some more time. You have to do the problems once again. If you have any doubt, contact to my number. Bye, children.